In a town named Houghton, there lived a woman named Shelley. She had a son, whose name was Samuel. Samuel was a very decent boy. He used to work in a well-known organization. One day, Samuel went to a flower shop to buy a bouquet for an office function. So, to buy a bouquet, he goes to a flower shop, where he had already picked a bouquet, when suddenly he sees a girl standing in front of him and asking, "Sir, if you have chosen this bouquet, shall I pack this?"
"Yes, pack this one. How much for it?"
300 rupees, sir."
"Here is your money. So, what's your name?"
"My name is Ruby. I sell flowers to make a living." After this conversation, Samuel left for office. But he kept thinking about Ruby. He was confused why he was getting all these feelings. One day, Samuel came to Ruby's flower shop and he sees Ruby. He bought a flower and gave it to her. And then Samuel to Ruby,
"Ruby, I like you a lot. Will you marry me?"
"Sir, I'm not an ideal match for you. You are rich and I'm poor. How is it possible?"
"I don't believe in such things. That is why I want to marry you."
"But will your family accept me as their daughter-in-law?"
"My mother will not. But if we get married before she knows, then she will."
"Is it so?"
"Yes."
"Then I'm ready to marry you." After hearing this, Samuel decided to get married by the next month. During this time, Ruby and Samuel took time to understand each other and they started liking each other. After hearing this, Samuel decided to get married by the next month. During this time, Ruby and Samuel took time to understand each other and they started liking each other. After that, they got married in a temple. And after getting married according to his promise, Samuel took Ruby to his house. Seeing Samuel, his mother got very happy. But seeing a girl with him, she asked him,
"Samuel, who is this girl with you?"
"Mom, this is Ruby. We got married. She is your daughter-in-law now."
"What are you saying, Samuel? I have found so many suitable matches for you. And you got married to this poor girl?"
"Mom, please don't say anything to her. I have married her with my own wish. And I don't care about social status. All that matters to me is the person, not their social status."
Listening this, Shelley said,
"Okay, if you say so, I will accept her as my daughter-in-law. But she will have to learn our manners and etiquettes."
"I will learn, Mom." After saying this, Samuel and Ruby go to their room. And the next day, Ruby goes to the kitchen and prepares delicious food for them and does all the household chores. But her mother-in-law, Shelley, was not liking it as they got married against her will. So one day, Shelley to Ruby,
"Hey Ruby, make some tea for me."
"Sure Mom, getting it." After that, Ruby prepares tea for Shelley, but it takes a little longer. So Shelley to Ruby,
"Ruby, are you making tea or some kind of dessert?"
"No Mom, here it is, I got it." Shelley then has a sip of tea. After having the tea, Shelley likes it so much. But just with an intention to humiliate Ruby, she said,
"Ruby, learn how to make tea properly. It doesn't taste good at all."
"Mom, shall I bring another cup of tea for you?"
"No, leave it. Don't do like this. By making tea twice, you will only waste my son's money."
Ruby doesn't say anything. And after some time, Ruby leaves to do other household chores. That day, Shelley had piled up lots of clothes for Ruby to wash and then,
"Ruby, Ruby, listen, here are some clothes, go wash them."
After coming there, Ruby sees a pile of clothes. Seeing that, Ruby says to her mother-in-law, "Okay Mom, I will wash them, you don't worry." Saying so, Ruby finishes other household chores and washes 3 buckets clothes and to dry them, she takes them on the terrace. After some time, when Ruby comes back from the terrace, she sees her mother-in-law has come back from the garden and haven't cleaned her feet and kept roaming in the house with dirty feet. Seeing this, Ruby understands her mother-in-law's motive and Shelley says,
"See Ruby, how soiled the house looks. Go clean it quickly."
"Okay Mom, I will clean it in a while." Saying so, Ruby cleans the house and to serve food, she comes to the kitchen to warm the food and serve it to everyone. She quickly warms all the food and then everyone sits to have food. Ruby serves everybody's plate. That's when Samuel says to Ruby,
"Ruby, the food tastes really good."
Hearing this, Ruby smiles, but Shelley was not at all happy. Thinking something in her mind, she eats the food and goes to sleep in her own room. The next day, while Ruby was cooking, suddenly she remembers some other work and leaves the kitchen. That's when Shelley comes to the kitchen and adds lot of chili powder in the food and lots of salt in the other dishes she had prepared. After doing this, Shelley goes and sits in the hall. After some time, Shelley says to Ruby,
Ruby, haven't you cooked anything today?
Yes, Mom, I did. Let me serve it to you.
No, not now. Let Samuel come, then we will all eat together.
Okay, Mom, I'll finish some other works by then.
Okay.
Saying so, Shelley kept reading newspaper in the hall and then Samuel comes home. Seeing him, Ruby says,
Hey, here you are. Mom was waiting for you to have meal together.
You go and serve. I'm coming in a while.
Saying so, Samuel goes to freshen up. Then Ruby warms the food and sets the table and serves it. She gets everything ready. Then Ruby calls her mother-in-law.
Mom, come. I have served the food.
Yes, coming.
Saying so, Shelley smiles and comes to the table to have the meal. Samuel also joins her and both of them sit to eat together. Then Shelley takes one bite of the food and she finds it very spicy and spits it out there.
Yuck, yuck, yuck. You idiot. Do you want to kill me or what?
What happened, Mom?
What have you mixed in the food? It's so spicy. I can't even eat this.
Mom, why are you saying so? Ruby cooks so well.
You taste it yourself and then say.
Samuel takes a bite and spits it out in a second. And then he says to Ruby.
Ruby, how have you cooked today? How could you add so much salt and chili powder in the food?
I don't know how it happened. I added salt and chili in proper amount.
Ruby, don't make such mistakes from the next time. If you will do so, Mom will become angry on you.
Yes, I will remember next time.
Okay, throw this food away and prepare something new. I'm waiting outside.
Okay, I'm preparing.
Saying so, Ruby goes to the kitchen to cook something new. But she thinks in her mind,
how all this happened? I had added salt and chili powder in the proper amount. How did that happen then?
Then Ruby quickly prepares the meal and calls them after setting the table. And then they sit down to have food. Ruby felt very happy after seeing them eat peacefully. Then Ruby said to Samuel,
Hey, thank you so much for understanding me and giving me another chance.
How could we not come? Otherwise, we had to sleep hungry all night.
Can this ever happen, that I could let you sleep hungry?
Okay, I'm going to sleep. You finish your work and come.
Okay, I'm coming after finishing my work.
Saying this, Ruby goes back to finish other household chores and Samuel goes to sleep. And Shelley also goes to sleep and she feels very happy. She starts thinking,
I have taught a lesson to that Ruby today.
Saying this, Shelley sleeps happily that night. The next day when Shelley was sitting in the hall, a distant relative Irene comes to their house.
Is somebody in the house?
Irene, please come. So what made you come here today?
I have come bearing a good news for you. I have found a suitable match for your son. They are very rich and you will get lots of dowry also.
It's of no use now.
What happened? Why are you talking like this?
My son got married without telling me. Now it's of no use.
Listen, Shelley, if you will send your daughter-in-law away, you can get lots of money and your son's future will also get secured.
Yes, you are right. I have to do something.
Okay, I have to go now.
Saying this, Irene leaves. And Shelley keeps thinking about it in her mind. That's when Ruby goes to the terrace to dry clothes. And Shelley thinks to herself and says to herself,
If I push Ruby from the terrace, no one will get to know about it. And no one will ever doubt on me also.
Thinking so, Shelley goes to the terrace where Ruby was hanging clothes to dry. That's when Shelley tries to push her from the terrace, but Ruby goes in the other direction. As Shelley was coming in a hurry, she stumbles and falls on the terrace, and she gets injured. Then Ruby goes to her and says,
Mom, how did you fall? Give me your hand and try to get up.
Shelley was in great pain. She gave her hand to Ruby. With the help of the neighbors, Ruby brought her mother-in-law to the hospital for treatment. Her hands and legs were fractured and was tied with plaster and bandage. That's when Shelley thinks on her own,
"My daughter-in-law is so kind. Despite of my bad behavior towards her, she is taking care of me. I was wrong about her. I had misunderstood her."
Then Shelley says to Samuel,
"Samuel, my daughter-in-law's heart is pure gold. How I could have survived without her today?"
"Mom, don't say like that."
"Mom, you take rest. We can continue this conversation later."
"No, son. I have to say this, Samuel. I have always misunderstood her. But I was wrong. My daughter-in-law is very nice and obeys to whatever I say and never complains about it."
While talking about this, Shelley starts crying and Ruby wipes her tears.
"Mom, don't cry. Take some rest. I'm here only, okay?"
After some days, Shelley comes back home and Ruby took good care of her. Shelley made peace with Ruby. Seeing this, Samuel was also happy. From this story we learn, we should never wish bad for others. People who wish bad for others, God makes bad things happen to them. As it is said, you reap what you sow.
Hello friends. They say that whatever has to happen will happen. Perhaps Melissa, who became IS, knew this. This is a story of a poor girl, Melissa. Melissa, a 22-year-old girl, was cooking in her mistress' house. Actually, Melissa used to cook in people's houses along with doing her studies. She wanted to become an IS officer. While cooking, she asked her mistress one day, "Ma'am, for what exam are your sons preparing?" The mistress gets angry hearing this and she scolded Melissa saying,
"Do your work. Why do you need to know about my son? What is he doing? Do your work and go from here. Instead of wasting your time in studying, do the cleaning of my house. You will get some more money and your economic condition will be better."
That day, Melissa felt very bad. Actually, her mistress said everything sarcastically. Melissa came home and started studying as usual. She went to her mistress's house to cook in the morning. That day, mistress was in a good mood. Mistress told Melissa,
"Melissa, did you have some work with Andrew?"
Andrew was mistress's son and was preparing for UPSC exams. Andrew was at home that day.
"Ma'am, I just wanted to ask, for which exam is Andrew sir preparing for?"
Mistress immediately told Melissa, "Do one thing. You stay here today and talk to Andrew regarding your studies and do some more work for me." Melissa was very happy. Now the mistress told, "Melissa, you need to cook food for 15 people tonight. Will you cook?" Melissa agreed to it immediately because she needed some books for the UPSC exam. And Melissa knew that Andrew was also preparing for UPSC exams. She would get the books she needed when asked for them. It was late that night and Melissa cooked food for 15 people. She asked her mistress,
"Ma'am, please call brother Andrew. I have to ask him something."
But as mistress's work was complete by then, she made her complete the work and lied to her that
Andrew has gone to his friend's house and maybe he will not come back tonight.
This made Melissa sad because she had completed all the books she had and she wanted new books. But she had not much money left to buy new books. Right then, Andrew comes out of his room calling his mother. Now the lie of mistress was apparent. But in order to manipulate her words, she said,
"Son, you were with your friends, isn't it?"
Melissa wanted to ask you about studies. Now Andrew asked Melissa,
"Okay, what do you want to know?"
Then Melissa told Andrew that she was preparing for the UPSC exam. But she didn't have money to join coaching classes or buy books. She asked him, how can she prepare for the exams? Considering Melissa's condition, Andrew told Melissa,
"Hey, how did you even think of appearing the UPSC exam? Do you know that this exam is a very big one and you will have to compete with students from well-known colleges? You will not be able to do that. Why are you wasting your hard-earned money on books and coaching?"
Saying that, Andrew went back to his room and mistresses asked Melissa to go home by telling her that Look, Melissa, there is already many people in our house today. There is no place left to sleep. You go back to your home.
It was 11:30 at night, and a poor, alone girl was going back home. She was tired and started crying because Andrew had laughed at her condition. Melissa was so tired that her body was unable to cope. But the same night, Melissa promised to herself that she will take revenge of Andrew's insult. She would show that a poor girl who studied from a normal college can also become an IAS. Melissa prepared her timetable that night. She decided that after cooking dinner in her mistress's house, she would study at home for at least 7 hours in the night and 3 hours during the day. Melissa made a timetable for 10 hours, but the biggest problem was of books. From where would she get the money for the books? Then she decided that she would ask her mistress son for books. Maybe he would give her the books. After thinking this, she went to sleep. In the morning, after completing her 3 hours of study, Melissa came to her mistress's house. Andrew was sleeping. So Melissa told her mistress that,
"Ma'am, if you want, I will do some more work for you. I will wash your car too. But can you give me 500 extra every month for that? I will buy books to study."
By chance, the mistress was happy that day. She told her,
"Look, I cannot give you the money, but I can let you have Andrew's books. You can return them after studying as soon as possible."
Melissa became very happy. Andrew started giving his books to Melissa when her mother asked him for that. Now, Melissa doubled the speed of her study. The books, which were eating dust in Andrew's cupboard, were now being properly used. 4 months were due for UPSC's pre-exam, and Melissa had completed the entire syllabus for 4 months in advance because she was aware of the value of the books. Andrew was busy in some other world rather than preparing for UPSC. But to show off in front of his mother, he used to ask the books back in 2 or 3 days from Melissa. Now Melissa started revising for exam, and one day, while cooking, she asked her mistress that,
"Ma'am, how is brother Andrew's preparation going on?"
Right then, Andrew came there and pointed out Melissa's status. But today, Melissa was not the one whom he had insulted 6 months before while giving the books. Andrew started asking about the number of papers in UPSC from Melissa, on which Melissa explains the entire syllabus in 2 minutes, and asked Andrew a question on a recent event on the international affair. But poor Andrew was not aware of the current affairs needed for UPSC exam. He manipulated the words and pointed out at Melissa's status. He went away from there. Now, time passed and the pre-UPSC exams arrived. Melissa passed the exam, but Andrew could not pass. He told that he did not appear in the exam that year. Melissa had passed, but she did not tell her mistress and Andrew about that. Now it was the time for the mains. Melissa doubled her hard work and succeeded in mains. She started waiting for the interview call. But the day she was supposed to go for the interview, her mistress forced her to come for work. She told her that if she doesn't come that day, then her services will no longer be needed. But Melissa decided that she would not go there that day because she had to go for the UPSC building for the interview. There the interview ended, and here the mistresses fired Melissa. Melissa waited for the final result. The UPSC results were out and Melissa got rank 369. Yes, Melissa had scored rank 369. Melissa was very happy. A poor village girl had excelled in UPSC exam and had become an IAS officer. When Andrew came to know about the UPSC results, he went to Melissa's house and asked her about her strategy. Her mistress too had come to Melissa's house for the first time with Andrew. Melissa thought that there was a day when her mistress and Andrew used to point out her status. But Melissa was not like Andrew, and so she shared her strategies with Andrew. After that, Melissa left for IAS training. Friends, Let's hope that the important moment of Melissa's life moves you all a lot, helps you get attracted towards your studies, helps you proceed and achieve your goal in a good manner. I hope that after seeing this story, you all will improve yourselves.